having moment.
Oh my god. And an R at the end. Or are you on a building site?
Just having my morning decaf.
You practicing for your role on Hollyoaks?
Shh, we're not talking about that yet.
Oh, sorry, I thought you were in character because of the way you slurp your tea.
Hi, Annabelle, I miss you!
I know, I haven't seen you in so long. What the fuck?
Oh, we're doing remote recordings these days, and it's very difficult for me.
Yeah, it's weird. It's weird to go from seeing each other every week to seeing each other never.
Not having that weekly dose of physical contact where I just hug you to death.
I know, it is fucking weird. I actually have to go to LA next week, so let's get together.
Oh, what are you coming here for? Your Botox appointment?
Oh, yeah, and my boob job that I've been planning to get. It's a really quick turnaround these days. The technology is amazing. No, I'm coming to see a friend that's in town from Germany who I haven't seen since before COVID. So.
Oh, wow. Can Germans fly here now?
She's American.
Oh, she's American. Got it.
Yeah. They gave her, like, compassionate right to remain in Germany because America's such a fuck show.
Oh, wow.
They were like, yeah, you probably should be German now.
Well, that's pretty funny that being a German is better than being an American these days.
Oh, my God. Germany's a great place to live.
I know. I'm just teasing. I love my Germans and I love Germany. I do. Where have you been in Germany?
I went to Berlin and one other place when I was on tour there. And I did, so you know what it's like on tour. You don't really get to see everything most of the time. But I loved it there. It was the place I was thinking I was going to like the least. And I loved it. The people were so friendly. The gigs were great. People just love music there. And they're so enthusiastic about music. It just made me feel really good about myself. And I thought that the club culture there was really like cool and fun. So I loved Germany. I had some great soup in Germany. And that's a weird
great
thing
soup.
To remember. Yeah, it's such a weird thing to remember. But I had such a yummy soup there. I was actually thinking about that the other morning, thinking like, why do I remember the soup?
That's so good.
It's hilarious. I know, it's so stupid. But what have I had going on? Do you know what? I've had such a like unglamorous week of just really boring shit.
You've been saying that for weeks and I know it's not true.
I know what I can tell you that's exciting.
What?
Well, first let me tell you, which I will tell the listeners, that last night I came home from dinner and my little Kit Kat was really unwell. You may remember when I took him to the vet a few weeks ago when I first found him, they let me know that he was in the final stages of kidney failure, which I think I mentioned last week as well. Yeah. And I said I was just going to let him rip and live his life. And I knew I would know when it was time. And last night I came home and it was time. So we cuddled it with him for an hour. And we wrapped him up in a little blankie and we took him to the vet and he just pressed his head into mine and I told him like how good he was going to feel, you know, like he was going to, and he just leaned into me and he was ready. Like he very much came back to be like taken care of. And what was so crazy is that he'd been gone for like 3 or 4 days and a couple people had seen him, but he hadn't come back here. And I'd been like, okay, maybe he's moved on to another family or maybe he's gone off to die or whatever. And last night when we came back from dinner, I said to my friend, do you think that Kit Kat will come home when it's time so that we can take care of him? Like, I worry that he's just going to go and try and be stoic and like be in a bush or go to somebody else or something's going to happen. And I just, I'd been willing and praying for him to come back when it was time. And lo and behold, we walk into the fucking house and the cat's on the counter and he's, you know,
he
and
says
it's time. I know. I just couldn't. We just looked at each other like we cannot believe we just had that conversation. Literally at the gate, like sitting in the car, and then we walk in and there he is.
Wow.
But it was really peaceful and we recently had to put another pet down. And I was so overwhelmed that I couldn't be with her because I was crying too much and I wanted to be really strong and I couldn't. So I had to let somebody else be with her, my sister be with her. And I regretted it afterwards, even though I knew it was the right thing to do. I really regretted not feeling strong enough to be there. And I made a promise to myself that that wouldn't happen again.
Yeah.
So it was a really beautiful experience to just put my own shit aside and just like usher him into the next thing.
I know what you mean. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you do. You had to do it with Ivy.
Yeah. When I put her down, I was so scared. I was so scared of just all of it. And it was terrifying. It was horrific. And I that's what pulled me through, was realizing that I didn't want her last hours and moments to be full of tears. I wanted it to be full of singing. I mean, we actually sang to her on the way in the car. We were singing this stupid little song that I made up that I would always sing to her. And she was answering me back. And and she was meowing back. And we just tried to laugh and tell her how amazing it was where she was going and how much we appreciated the time we'd had with her. And you just got to make it a celebration, don't you?
Yeah, and it was like a game changer, that experience. It really was, because it felt like an honor and
it
a privilege.
Is an honor. Yes.
Rather than like, oh, I'm so... And I walked away. I obviously, as soon as he was gone, I cried a lot, but I walked away feeling humbled by the whole thing and just so grateful that he came home.
Yeah, it's so humbling and it's such an honor. And I agree, the second they're gone, you just fall apart. But what happened after she left is I just kept saying, you did so good.
Yeah.
I was so proud of her.
Yeah.
And myself and both of us. And, it's really a life-changing experience.
It is. And I think that, I don't know, between the two of us, we've had lots of pets have to be, you know, said goodbye to recently. Yeah. And I think it's just nice to know, for us both to learn and to share, that it's like you actually can be really strong in those moments. You don't have to just fall apart if you focus on the animal and then like fall apart afterwards.
Yeah, exactly.
It's an honor to have to be.
The lesson is it's an honor to have to be strong for anyone.
Yeah, it was really interesting. But obviously, I'm going to miss him loads.
That was just last night.
Yeah.
Wow.
But that's I just wanted to let people know, because some people write me about him and send me videos, and a lady sent me lots of like gifts for him and everything. So the people were invested in Kit Kat.
Yeah.
And he didn't let us down. He stayed true till the end. He was a good boy.
And the same with Ivy. I got so many listener just comments and poems, and my little students drew me pictures and cards, and people are
you're
very
so sweet.
thank you for being nice to us. Caring, yeah.
I know, yeah, definitely. So I dealt with that last night, but other than that, I've really had not that much going on. The exciting thing, which I'm very excited about, is that last week I booked my ticket back to England.
Did you really?
I did.
What?
Yeah.
When are you going? Can you tell us or is it a secret?
Yeah, I'm going to go on December the 1st.
Oh my goodness. So you'll be there for Christmas?
Yes, I'm going to be there for Christmas, and it's my mum's 70th birthday, so I'm going on the 1st so that if anything does go wrong and I have to quarantine for 14 days, I'll be out by the time it's
over. God knows. Yeah, if you have to fly there twice or anything.
I know. it just gives me enough time for something, if it goes wrong, to fix it.
Hawaii vibes.
Yeah, exactly. No Hawaii vibes. So I'm actually really excited.
That's fabulous. That's not that long away.
No, it's not. So we got a haul ass to get the shed done. And it felt really nice to make a plan that I wanted to make rather than that I had to make because my life exploded.
Yeah.
You know,
this is kind of the first time you've had free will in a while.
Yeah, exactly. And so, and I feel really excited about it because, as you know, like plans have been feeling daunting. Yeah. And this, I don't feel daunted by, I feel excited by. And then also, I booked a tour of Highclere Castle, which is where they filmed Downton Abbey.
I'm so excited.
Oh my God. I know. I am like such a nerd. I'm beside myself excited about it. Okay. I've wanted to do this for so long. And I'm doing it at Christmas time. It's going to be so magical. I've already looked at all of the gifts in the gift shop. I cannot wait to get the t-shirt, the hat, the mug, the pencil.
Wow.
I know. I'm so excited.
Wait. Can we record the podcast from Highclere or something?
I know. I would love to sneak in
your computer and just set up in a corner.
No, but I'll make lots of videos.
Yes.
I'm so excited. I'm so fucking excited.
So great.
I know. It feels nice to make plans and be excited about them and not be like terrified of them.
Yeah.
So that's my news for my personal life.
I've got some good material to try to make you laugh today. I figured we could all use some laughter in our lives today, because coming off of our discussion about healing last week, we were comparing it to bed rest and being down with a physical injury. And what do you need when you're stuck in bed? You need comedy. So
a good laugh, yeah.
Exactly. So I think that a good point to remind ourselves of is that it's very important to have humor while you're healing.
Yeah, laughter is like the best stress reliever ever, other than sex. It's true. Really, like, just feels good in the body.
Laughter and sex at the same time, I'm not so sure about, but
maybe after. Bit of after laughter. It's fine.
After laughter.
If you're laughing during, something's wrong, honey.
Something's not quite right, exactly. Well, Will and I had our first concert, his American
debut. Didn't know where that was going.
Speaking of laughing during sex. Will, I love you. I'm just kidding. Will had his debut performance here in Los Angeles.
I know. You guys, I watched it on live. It was fantastic.
Oh, it was so much fun, and I sang with him.
And your boobies looked great.
My boobs were falling all over the place, but, you know, people haven't been out in a while. You gotta.
If anyone wants to see that, by the way, the performance is great, but if anyone wants to see Lucy's tits, go on Will Sweeney's page. Great video. Love
So we were so exhausted after the show. We stayed in bed literally for 24 hours on Sunday. And it was the best day of my life. My favorite thing now is staying in bed all day.
Isn't it? See, when I met you, that would have been unthinkable to you.
Can you imagine?
No, you would have freaked.
Yeah, no.
You literally wouldn't have been able to do it. But now, look at you. Rest, I know. Baby. Rest.
I'm a pro. Love this. But the concert was wonderful. He sounded amazing, and I was just...
He really did, babe.
I'd never seen him perform, and he'd never seen me perform, and for us to be performing together after all this time, because we met in quarantine, and so we've literally never seen each other in action. Why do I keep saying literally? I don't know.
Literally, you're like literally totally from California, and you're literally having the best time on your podcast.
If I'm going to say it, I have to say it the English way, which is literally.
Literally. That was really a great show. I'm so glad we could watch it live. Did he sort of literally, did he actually tape it to the thing? Like, actually? Did tape he tape what? His phone to the... Banister.
I did. Yeah, oh. because everyone in England, the venue said they were going to provide a live feed of the show, but then they didn't.
I noticed that because Alec and I were going to do the live thing, but luckily you guys had it on your Instagram.
Yeah, I'm not sure if they've really figured out how to reopen these venues. They're having kind of a hard time. I just went in the room and taped his phone up on a pillar and just... got it on Instagram Live.
It was great. The sound was great. It was a great angle. You nailed it. A+.
It was really wonderful time. So we got to perform together for the first time. Very special.
Was it sexy?
It was super sexy. I was like embarrassed by that because the whole audience started catcalling and making comments, and I didn't expect that at all. Like, we weren't going to mention anything or play up to that at all, but I got a little timid.
That's funny. But the audience could sense it.
The audience loved it. One girl was like, we were watching you and just imagining what you two were like in bed together.
Oh my God. Okay. A new corner of the market. Interesting. Yeah.
Well, there have been others before us, you know, Johnny Cash and June Carter, Tim and Faith.
No one's doing it right now.
No. Anyway, we've got some news.
Oh, God, yeah, the news. It's not world news. It's not
important news.
It's Lucy and Annabel
news. Oh, we almost got there.
Almost. We're definitely going to have to pre-record that.
You stole my line, though. Why did you go for my line?
I told you, not a good actress. Really bad one. Okay, so the news. I'm going to start with my shits, borings, rubbish, crap.
What do you got for us, Annabelle?
Lena Dunham marries Lewis Felber in surprise nuptials.
Who's that and who's that? No, I'm just kidding. Who's the guy?
Well, the guy, he's Peruvian and he's a songwriter. And actually, I used to fool around with him a little bit.
Whoa, the plot thickens.
Yeah, only a couple times. It wasn't all that. But
wait, what do you mean? You can't just skip over that. That's part of the news also.
When I used to play in like folk music world in London, mm-hmm. there was a bar that I used to play at called Nambuka, which burned... You guys can't see this if you're just listening, Gilbert is being thrust around in the corner like he's levitating.
We'll do it again.
Will, you are brave because that cat is really aggressive sometimes.
Will, you're brave. All right, so wait, so you were playing these folk clubs in
London. Blah, 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 blah. And there was this one bar called Nambuka that we used to have to play at all the time, and I fucking hated playing there, and eventually it burned to the ground, which everyone else was upset by, but I was thrilled by.
Annabelle, we know you have a history with fire. Anything you want to tell us?
It wasn't me. It was...
Okay.
It was the gods on my behalf.
You but always anyway. Rub your forehead when you're lying.
No, I'm doing that thing. I can't stop feeling my face. But basically, I met Lewis Felber at Nambuka. And he was sexy. Like, he was used to wear, like, gothy clothes. And he was just, like, hot. And I was 17 or 18 or something. And he had another girlfriend. And then he was, like, breaking up with her. And then him and I, like, ding-a-linged. I don't think we actually ever had sex. I think we just... like fiddle faddled, we did.
What's your definition of fiddle faddle? Just kissing,
just like
bumping around in the shadows,
just flip flopping, flip flobbing, slip slobbing,
naked flipper flapping.
Exactly. But honestly, I don't even know if I was fully naked. But when I saw the post come up, I was like, "What fucking hell? That's Lewis Felber."
She stole my man.
Oh no, she's best wishes to both of them. They're great together.
I thought she was a lesbian.
No. She's not a lesbian.
Okay.
Lena has a lot of health problems. She was in the hospital and Lewis had to leave, obviously, after a certain amount of time. And he stayed longer than he was meant to stay. And then he thought, when you got home, I didn't like seeing you like that. And the next day when you got back and you were in bed, he said, I don't want you to ever go through that on your own again. I want to marry you someday. And then she was like, why don't we make that someday soon? And then they got married the next day.
Are you still reading the news, or was that like insider information you just had?
No, I read that.
It was very personal. I felt like I was in the room with them.
I read it off of the Daily Mail, which is my favorite celebrity website. Wow. And there's, if anyone wants to see pictures of the nuptials, then it is on her Instagram. And that is my news, baby. Thrill of the century.
Oh my God.
Lena Dunham. It's finally been taken off the market by Louis Felber of Peru and London.
Well, thank you for enlightening us.
You're so welcome. I know you guys really rely on me for all that stuff, so.
Well, I can one-up ya.
Please do.
Did you know that McDonald's once made bubblegum-flavored broccoli to try to get the kids to eat healthier?
That's so disgusting. It's so disgusting.
It says, this test didn't go well with child testers who were, quote, confused by the taste.
Yeah, that is really confusing. But you know what is delicious? Have you had cotton candy grapes?
Yes.
Oh, my obsession. We're obsessed with them in this house.
I could eat 10 bags. They're no, so good.
It's so, like, we're obsessed with them.
They sell them at Gelson's, by the way.
They sell them at Gelson's. No, we found them at Sprouts.
Oh.
And they're $3.99 a pound at Sprouts. Guys, this is thrilling. And they're $8.99 a pound at Gelson's. So I went there and I thought that they were $8.99 for a bag. Well, they weren't. They were $8.99 a pound. It cost me about $28.
No, you did not on grapes.
I know. I got home and I checked my bill and I was like, why was this $100? I got like five things. It's because my fucking grapes cost $30. And I didn't take them back because I was just like, for fuck's sake, I can't be bothered.
Yeah, how do you return grapes?
I'll just take the L. But by the way, hot insider information, if you're in America, in California, put them in the freezer. Best treat ever.
Well, the Gelson's bag, that's like $4 a grape.
It really is a complete ripoff. Don't buy those ones unless you're desperate and you can't go another second without the cotton candy grape.
Gelson's is a rip in general.
Oh god, I love Gelson's. It's my secret.
I do too.
Treat.
I shop there all the time.
I know.
Okay, here's my next newsworthy fact.
Okay.
Did you know? And this is completely not confirmed. Okay.
Okay.
Did you know? But it's breaking serious news. Did you know that armadillo shells are bulletproof?
That's not true. Come on.
In fact, one Texas man was hospitalized when a bullet he shot at an armadillo ricocheted off the animal and hit him in the jaw.
Okay, one of the first things that comes up on Google here is, are armadillos bulletproof?
What does it say? Because, listen, as any professional news person, I check my facts before I present them as news, okay? So,
well, obviously I haven't checked them very well because that's not true. It says armadillos, despite reports of bullets ricocheting off of armadillos, these creatures aren't bulletproof. Their shells are made of bone that grow on the skin.
I knew it. That's why I didn't want to Google it, because I knew that that would happen.
Yeah, I'm really sorry. I mean, I like the story of the Texas man getting...
I do too.
Yeah, I like that.
That's newsworthy. That's newsworthy. Yeah. A guy got hit in the jaw with a bullet after he tried to shoot a poor defenseless animal.
Good for that armadillo.
Serves him right.
Yeah. Fucking Texas man.
All right, well, I guess that's the end of our news. Thank you.
Great news. Thanks. Great news segment. So I'm interested to know what these funny things that you've got in mind are, because you're like, I want to do funny things.
All right, why don't you snuggle up in your
I love funny
in your bed.
No, I'm not.
Get
in
that
bed.
Blankie around you, everybody. Just get your blankie. Just get comfy. Prepare to laugh. So this is a list of things that are embarrassing for no reason.
Oh my god, no, I hate being embarrassed by things. I don't like it. I'm not embarrassed by, like, so say something embarrassing happens to me, I don't get embarrassed by those things, but like if I see something cringe, I want to disappear. I can't physically handle it. And my family, my sister Sarah, thinks it's like such a lame and silly funny trait about me, is that I just like physically recoil from like people being loud, or like drunk people doing embarrassing things, or if like somebody I'm with laughs really loud, I just beetroot face.
I love it. I'm definitely going to keep that in mind.
No.
By the way, my cat is going crazy playing with this little blue ball that he loves. So
good.
He's probably doing it in honor of Kit Kit.
Good.
So sorry about the noise, but he's having a good time. All right. So this list is things that are embarrassing for no reason. Here we go.
Yeah.
Walking towards someone you're meeting up with from a long distance.
Yeah, that is. So what do you do in that situation?
Well, here's what I do, because that's how Will and I first met. When I flew to England to meet him, we were at the airport, which was completely empty because it was COVID. So it was just him and I. And we saw each other from like 200 feet yards. I don't even know. It was like a football field. And so we start walking towards each other. What did I do? I just stopped in my tracks and I made him walk all the way to me. I just
froze. That's so romantic.
I froze. I was so mortified. I didn't know what to do, and I just stopped.
As an English person, I like to really just diffuse the embarrassment with silliness and be like, ooh.
Start doing stupid walks.
Throw a funny walk in there.
I mean, you got to pull a Monty Python with the School of Ridiculous Walks or whatever it is.
Or just Forrest Gump it. Just run.
Just take off running and tackle them. Yeah. Okay. So exiting from the middle of a row, super awkward.
Oh, no. The worst. Sorry.
And you just can tell they're just like, fucking fuck.
And are you meant to face backwards so your ass is in their face? Or are you meant to face forward so you're like pussy and tits are in their face?
Yes.
And like they don't know where to look. And then
they're trying to put their legs to the side, but there's not enough room. Oh, no.
Do you go face first or back? Or like
I go back.
Yeah.
I go shoulder and side.
Just don't perceive me. Don't look at me.
And then the worst, even worse than that, is coming back and having to get back in the row.
Oh, sorry. I know. Sorry again.
Okay. Someone holding the door open for you when you're too far away. That's a bad one.
No, that's just rude of them.
It's rude.
Yeah, you're not being helpful. You're actually being rude. And
it's like, wasn't there yet.
Yeah, and what if I wanted to stop outside and like check my phone first, or like...
Now you're rushing me and I'm speeding up and I'm like reaching my arm out super far.
You know, no. I have to be awkward and embarrassing. Because of you. You really wanted to be a nice person.
Chivalrous.
Okay, that is really... So that reminds me... Actually, I don't know whether we should... Maybe I can tell it now because...
Tell it.
And then we can lead on, maybe next episode we can talk about this.
Okay.
I was on a walk the other day and this woman was struggling. Like she has this old vintage car in her driveway and the house is all like weird and hoarderish and like decrepit. And she's... Mm-hmm. When I take my walks in the evenings, she's frequently playing the piano in there. So definitely like mad genius vibes.
Love it.
So she's in her driveway and she's reaching her arm like backwards into her car, like fiddling around through the window. She's obviously like locked herself out of her car or something. And she's grimacing in pain and going, oh. she's like really not doing a good job and she looks like she's struggling. So I went, excuse me. Hello. Would you like some help? And she's like, no. Why would I want help? I know. And I was like, because it just looks really hard what you're doing. And I thought maybe I could help. And she pulled her arm out. And she's like, I don't need help. Don't be a weirdo. I know.
She told you to not be a weirdo.
And then she rummaged around again. And I was just standing there just like, aghast, just
the pot calling the kettle black.
And then she walked out from the side of her car. She put her feet like hip distance apart and she put her arms down by her sides and she went, "You did not just help me."
No, she didn't.
She did.
This story's true.
It is true. It happened to me the other day and I was just like, oh no, this is really embarrassing for all of us.
Well, that's a whole topic we can get into.
So that's what I wanted to, that is exactly what it made me think of. Because yeah, my response to her was really unevolved. I just said, yeah, go fuck yourself then. And I walked off. I said, oh, go fuck yourself then. As I walked off, I was like, fucking psychopath. And then as I was walking, I was like, I wish I hadn't reacted like that. And I wish I'd actually stopped and been like, what's wrong with a bit of help?
What, yeah, why so that would have been like, an interesting answer.
I know. And I wish I had the kind of, I wish I was evolved enough to respond that way in the moment, but I wasn't.
Well, you can go back and interview her this week.
Yeah. If I see her again, I'm going to ask her.
We're doing an episode on people accepting help. Can you explain to me what the fuck happened the other day?
I don't think she would remember. She had a real wild look in her eyes. I don't think she's quite all that. But
yeah, no, it doesn't sound like it.
But she was very pretty. She looked like one of like the Manson family. But
they were good looking.
Older. Yeah. Like she looked like a sexy cult member who's now older. Mm-hmm. Really wild look in her eye, yeah. Which I think is a part of the reason why I didn't engage with her, because I was like, this is like to trying to negotiate with a terrorist here. This is not going to end well.
Exactly.
But it made me think about offering people help and accepting help and how hard that is for people. And I think we should talk about that next episode.
Me too. Good idea. All right. You ready for some more?
Yeah, please. I love this game.
All right. Putting change back in your wallet. Is embarrassing for no reason. Tripping and then turning it into a jog.
Look at me. I'm like covering myself because I can't handle.
Like, you know when people trip and then they look back to like make like pretend like there was something there.
Yeah. No, I feel like the trip and jog is a very male way to fall. Whereas women, I feel, are more like,
women look back and go, what was that? Someone walking in on you singing, so you change it to a silly voice.
Well, maybe. I can see it, but I don't.
But you and me are singers, so I guess it's a little different. I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I find this one really true. I don't know if anyone else does. Walking back after you've bowled. Like walking back to the seats.
That's a really good one. See, that is one of the instances where I'm like, okay, time to do a silly walk.
I always do some stupid dance.
The finger guns come out. Hello, I'm white.
This is a bad one. And you'll get this because you worked in a shop. Leaving a store without buying anything. When you're the only customer kind of thing.
Why does that feel so bad?
Because you walk in and they go, hello, can I help you with anything? No, thank you, just looking. And then you have to be like, bye.
Bye.
I hate it. I hated your clothes. Bye.
Bye.
If you're there's me, nothing here I want.
Bye. Love you. Oh, I mean, you remember when I did that at the shop?
Yes. Trying to find a spare seat anywhere. Super uncomfortable. I know. It's really bad.
I hate this game and I love it. The same time.
People are just watching you look for a place to sit and they're not offering their chair.
It is really... It brings in this like instinctive pack feeling of me. It's like, is he gonna survive? I don't know.
He's the weak one.
Find out. Yeah,
he's the weak one that's gonna get roasted on the side by a predator.
If it was in the jungle, we'd all be like, watching it happen.
Oh my god! All right, more things that are embarrassing for no reason. having happy birthday sung to you.
Ban it. It should be banned. I think it should be banned.
Opening presents while everyone stares at you.
Well, I love presents, so I
do too. I fucking love presents. I take my time with presents. I piss people off. I take forever to open something. I marvel at the ribbon. I marvel at the tape. I give them compliments about their beautiful creasing. People are like, fucking get it over with. Oh my God. Being hit by a car and being okay. What the fuck? That's next level shit.
You'd be like, oh yeah, don't worry. Everyone, I'm fine.
I'm okay.
Everything's fine here. Nothing to see. All good.
Once I was on a horse in the dark.
No, why?
So stupid. My stepmom number four. I should say. She collects, like, abused horses and just gives them a happy life. Mm-hmm. And her bright idea was for us to all go on a night ride. And she gave me this fucking abused horse who was all flinchy. And I don't like getting on horseback anyway, but I was in the dark and he takes off running and my leg was like caught in something and I was over the back of him. It's a miracle I'm alive. And this was just a couple years ago.
It is a miracle.
While he's galloping with me dragging, my head is 6 inches from the ground and his hooves, I'm yelling, I'm okay. Everybody, I'm okay. Like, I felt awkward even in that moment. I felt so awkward.
That's so good. Is that Marjorie?
No, she's number five. I'm talking about number four.
That's your dad's had a lot of wives.
He does fancy the wives. Yeah, but isn't it interesting that more so than my own safety was my worry about it being uncomfortable for other people what was happening?
Yeah, I feel like that's the core of embarrassment.
All right, a few more things that are embarrassing for no reason.
I like this game so much.
Okay. Stopping at traffic lights on a bike.
That's not embarrassing.
I think it is.
You do? Do you not ride a bike very much? That's safe. That's safety first.
I know, but they just put their feet down and then they're just like resting with a helmet on their head. They just look stupid.
I think what's more embarrassing is like, do you ever just imagine everyone sitting in their cars but take the car away and think about how funny it is? That we're all just like, and you just look over to the person next to you, you're like, yeah, all right, hey.
I know. You ever make super awkward eye contact with someone in the car next to you and you just
and I feel like
don't know how to get out of it, so you just keep looking?
People do it to me all the time. I'm like, don't look at me. This is my private area. Don't.
But then you feel like you have to get out of it, like, nicely. So you just take your time and you're like, you don't want to, like, snap away from the gaze.
I snap away.
You just want to be like, you do?
Yeah, I'm like, get me out of here. I can't. I don't want to do this. I don't know you. I don't like this and I want it to end.
I have a hard time with the snapping away.
Yay.
I just take my time at getting out of it. Like, that didn't freak me out. We're fine. I meant to look at you. Got a couple more for you. Things that are embarrassing for no reason. This, for me, is an excruciating one. Saying goodbye and then walking the same direction.
That's awful. And just why? Just now. So what I try and do now, because I feel like COVID's given me a lot of time to think about these types of awkward interactions. And like, I'm going to problem solve them. So that is one of the things I've thought about a lot. And I'm just now going to say, oh, which way are you going?
That's a good idea.
I'll walk with you. So then you're not saying goodbye and walking in the same direction.
Or you make your decision to go the other direction, even if it's not what you had planned. You see, that's how far I would take it.
That's ridiculous.
Which way are you going? And then if they said the way I was going, I would change my entire day to not go that way.
Get a grip. That's awful.
That's how much I don't want to walk in the same direction after I say goodbye.
Just ask them which direction they're going before we say it. Before we say goodbye, what direction are you going? Because I'll walk with you if it's that way.
Why do you want to walk with them, though? That's the part I don't understand. The point is to go the other way because you said goodbye.
No, you... Okay. All right. I think the listeners have got my point. I'll just give you time to let it sink in.
I think they've got my point. Okay. Ooh, this is a good one. Reading something that someone has written for you in front of them.
Like a card.
Yeah, or like a poem or something. Like a letter. Has that ever happened to you where someone writes you like a letter and then they're like, can you read it right now? And you're just like, okay, in front of them. And then
I just make a point to be like, oh, I'm going to read that later just so I can really focus on it private. Really important. So I just want to, like, unlike what you did to me on my birthday, is you made me read the card, not just in front of you, but on air. And then you made me read it out loud on air. So...
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, so you're a punisher.
I think I'm that person. I actually think I might be that person.
Yeah, you are that person.
Read things in front of them.
You are.
Will shaking his head, yes. Oh, shut up, Will. You are too. All Will and I do is write each other lengthy notes and just read them out to each other.
Is that true?
No, you do it too. You write me the longest cards.
Oh, that's so sweet. Tell him I said
it's that. It's really sweet. Annabel says you're sweet, and the listeners do too. Come over here. You've never been on the pod. Come say hi. Come here.
I'm not dressed, or I haven't had a
You're not. You don't have to be on camera. Just come say hello to the listeners.
Hello, everyone. Hope you're having a wonderful episode so far. Sounds funny from where
I'm. You've been tittering from the peanut gallery in the other room. You've heard all of it.
The peanut gallery?
Yeah, it's an American saying. Don't worry about it. Okay, bye. I love you. Okay, a few more things and then we're off of this. Not knowing how to pronounce something on a menu when you order it.
Swallow me. Actually, swallow me. I'll just be like, can I have the... If it's like something with something else, I'll be like, oh, can I just have the, you know, the risotto?
Just point.
Yeah, I'm like, the risotto, I'll just... It's like risotto.
Yeah,
and I'm just like, I don't. Or this. I'll go, so sorry, how do I pronounce this?
Oh, that's good. I've never troubled. Is that another one that you troubleshot during COVID?
Yeah. Okay. Like, how can I diffuse my embarrassment in this situation and cope so that I don't want to be swallowed by the earth? And I go, excuse me, sir. Or... You know, whatever they are, we don't want to make the same mistake that you made in the restaurant.
Oh,
the other
excuse
day.
Me, they. Excuse me, they.
Excuse me.
Them. Excuse me. What?
No, you just say.
Oh, shit!
You just say, excuse me.
Excuse me. Excuse me. You know what, Annabelle? You know what I find amazing about both of your troubleshooting points?
Right, what?
Is that they just come down to communicating, you know?
Yep.
It's amazing the power of communication.
And
just
also.
Ask.
Asking, basically, you're asking for help. You're waving the white flag and going, help.
I don't know how to do this. I don't know which way to walk.
Mayday, please head back up. Please don't let me be embarrassed in front of all my friends.
Yes. Saying hi to someone at the supermarket and then bumping into them again in the store.
Awful.
Terrible.
Awful.
Hate it. Anytime I see someone I know in a supermarket, I put my head down and I run. I don't even finish my shopping. Actually, I set my bag down and I go.
No, you don't.
Because the thought of seeing them and saying hello and then having to see them on the next aisle is too much. I can't. I'm done shopping. I'll go to another store.
Lucy, you're not doing well with these. You've got to get a grip. You're really spending a lot of
I've got to get a grip. You're wrapped up in your fucking sweater up to your chin over there.
Yeah, and I'm coping.
Rubbing your face.
I'm coping and I'm staying in the eye of the storm. You are just bailing. You're dropping
your bags.
I'm just
saying what everyone wants to say. Everyone feels the same as I do.
Yeah, they do. But you guys got to get over it. Come on.
Everything to do with elevators.
Awful.
Taking too long to pack your groceries after you've paid. I always take my sweet time. I love pissing people off in line. I'm like, I waited in this line. I'm going to take my time. This is my moment. I get to take as long as I want to pack my groceries. And you're not going to rush me while I put my change back in my wallet. Yeah. I earned this. I earned this moment. And I am going to enjoy it. That's
I'm
how
just,
I feel.
I'm way too English for that. I also, the whole... somebody else packing your groceries for you. In England, you pack your own groceries. You never have help packing your groceries, ever.
I went to a store in England and I had to return something and they couldn't find the price tag to like scan it back in. And it took forever and there was a long line in back of me and I thought someone was going to murder me. You just don't do that stuff in England, do you?
That you do not do. You just bail. Not worth it. You're going to put a lot of other people in a situation that is uncomfortable. And as English people, we don't want to be uncomfortable. We don't want to have to be embarrassed. That's absolutely horrible for us. And also, we love to say, oh, sorry. Yeah, sorry. as much
like
as possible.
Americans don't know the word sorry.
No. So, yeah.
I tend to stay at the wrong times and then leave at the wrong times.
So not great awareness of the social cues of appropriate.
Did you know that I used to think that the word cue was Qwee-wee? That's how it's spelled.
That's a freak
in my name. Defense. In my defense, it's spelled Qwee-wee.
That is really special and sweet.
All right. Walking anywhere with someone you barely know.
No, love it.
Yeah, love it.
Absolutely love it.
I'm fine with that one. Wearing a backpack.
Yeah, definitely a bit like.
I think backpacks are so stupid and everyone wears them and I'm mortified for everyone.
Who wears them? No, I don't know anyone that wears
like
backpack,
a child. I don't know. A bunch of just hipster people. I don't like it.
No, backpacks aren't for... Sorry if this is sexist. Women shouldn't wear backpacks.
No, very not sexy. Girls, get your pussies on straight. Get it together. Get rid of that backpack.
Buy a purse, bitch. And if you got to buy a big purse and a little purse, and that's what you got to do.
Exactly.
Or buy a tote bag from our store.
Yeah. Buy the Lucy and Annabelle tote. There you go. Your credit card being declined. Mortifying. Terrible.
Awful.
Especially like if you're paying as a group and everybody puts their cards in and then yours comes back and they're like, oh, so sorry. Do you have another card? You're like, no. Do I look like I have another card?
Bitch, I ordered the soup. I don't have another motherfucking card.
I had an iced tea. Do I look like I have multiple cards to be fucking thrown down? Yeah, let me just get my black card out real quick. Sorry I didn't use that first.
Let me get the old Amex, the old titanium.
I used my fucking Wells Fargo first instead of my Amex, you know, just because.
Just for funsies.
Jesus. Not hearing somebody and making them repeat it multiple times.
Well, that's not embarrassing for me. It's actually infuriating. I am such a bitch with this stuff. My mom doesn't hear so well. She also chooses not to listen. Sorry, Mum, if you're listening, but you absolutely
love you, Mum.
Love you so much. And I'll say it and she'll go, what? And then she won't concentrate the second time. And I'm like, I am talking to you. Can you fucking hear me? Bitch. Like, she'll be like, oh, sorry, Annabelle. Just quit. I'm like, well, fucking turn the TV down then. God,
is that what your mother sounds like?
It's like,
sorry, Annabelle. My name is... You sound like the guy from Ferris Bueller. I want my daughter outside in 10 minutes.
It's like a running joke. And for years, I've been doing this, oh, Annabelle, don't do that impression of my mom. It's not what she sounds like. But for some reason, it's become the universal impression of Anita.
It's amazing.
But it does remind me of... Do you remember... You watched The Crown, did you not?
Yeah. Halfway through.
So... Oh, okay. So have you seen Margaret Thatcher yet?
No, not yet.
Okay, so you're going to love that voice. Like, straight up.
Oh, be right, Your Majesty. I've done my best.
It's like, bitch, why are you talking like that?
Oh, my God.
So I know that you're in, like, I know you're in character right now, but that is not what she sounded like.
Hello, would you like some kedri for dinner?
It's just
is that what your mom sounds like?
No, she doesn't, but it just reminded me of that. She's just
so...
I'm snorting. I'm
no, it's
snorting.
So annoying. She did such a good job. What's her name? Gillian Anderson?
I don't know.
Who did X-Files?
Yes.
Yeah, so she plays Maggie Thatcher in The Crown. And she does such a good job.
But the voice is completely insane.
And I texted my friend who's in casting, and I'm like, you got to be hearing this. This can't just be me. And she's like, thank you. Thank you. It is completely mad.
Well, how'd that slip through the cracks?
Bitch, I don't know.
Come on, Crown producers. What the fuck? I guarantee somebody got fired over that.
No one got fired. She was heralded for the role. Okay, is this the last one?
Last one.
Okay. God, we actually made it in the nick of time.
Takes the cake. Existing.
Yeah, it is just really, it's one showing of your ass after another, isn't
Jesus.
It?
Jesus. And there you go. That is shit that is awkward for no reason. Boom.
We would love to hear stuff that you guys find awkward. There's that classic meme, isn't there, online, where you're laying in bed and then you wake up and you think about something you did when you were like 15 or like 3 years ago that you said to a random person. We've all
You're
been
just
there.
Mortified.
Yeah, we've all been there. So we would love to hear your stories about everyday things that have mortified you to the point of perhaps spontaneous combustion.
Exactly. You can take your sweater off, but you're okay now.
Okay, I'm going to remove my blanket now.
Yeah, you're fine. You're safe. Okay. You're good. Do we have anything to end on from Jeff? We haven't heard from Jeff in a while.
Jeff, my therapist, good old Jeffrey. Let me see.
What's his
about
insight been lately? I'm going to be seeing my Jody therapist in the morning.
Jody
Looking
and Jeff,
to it.
What a bloody pair.
Jody and Jeff, rock stars.
So what was a big thing this week and has been since everything is learning that I can't protect everyone and I can't control everything. And with that little cat, I couldn't control it. I couldn't make it go away. And he was saying to me that that's true love. You do your best. You show up. You're there. You're not trying to control it. You're not trying to own it. It's freedom. Like, it should feel like freedom. Loving something should feel like freedom. And being loved should feel like freedom. And that's true empathy. And that's true love. And that's knowing yourself as well, being centered in yourself, which I thought was a beautiful way to sort of summarize the whole experience. And also just a lovely sentiment in general.
It is.
So
let's keep that in mind this week.
Can't wait to hear what Jody says.
Yeah, I know. She always drops those bombs of truth. This cat
is having a good time.
You know what I think? I think Kit Kit's here playing with the cat, and Ivy's here too, and Gilbert's just having the time of his life with his mates. That's
really
what's happening.
He really is on a rampage.
Ratty's here. She's running around.
No, she's staying well clear of that, of three cats. No, she's not stupid. She wasn't born
She's
yesterday.
Up on a shelf somewhere just looking at them. You suckers.
So that was his thoughts to me this morning.
That's perfect.
Yeah, I loved it. And don't worry, everyone. We all get embarrassed. You'll get over it. Love you.
Love you.
Don't believe everything that you breathe. You get a parking violation and a maggot on your sleeve. So shave your face with some mace in the dark. Saving all your fruit stand in front of the trailer park.